Everyone loves a good comeback story, especially about musicians. Artists are constantly reinventing themselves and their music to match public expectations. No one knows this better than Justin Bieber. Hey guys, what's up? I'm Lauren Mayhew, and we are here to give you the inside scoop on Bieber's path to stardom. So whether you can only admit to liking his new Purpose album, or you've had Bieber fever since the early YouTube days, we've got a little something for everyone. Number 1. Justin Bieber was born on March 1st, 1994 in London, Ontario at St. Joseph's Hospital. It's also the same hospital Ryan Gosling and Rachel McAdams were born in. Number 2. Bieber was, however, raised in Stratford, Ontario. He regularly refers to Stratford as his hometown. Number 3. His mom, Patty Millett, had him at age 18 and raised him as a single mother. Because of this, he puts a lot of emphasis on his family. Number 4. Bieber became fascinated with music early on in his life. The first instrument he ever taught himself to play was the drums, after his mom brought him a drum kit at age 4. Number 5. At age 8, he taught himself the guitar using an old one his mom had around the house. Justin struggled at first, since he was left-handed, but got the hang of it eventually. Number 6. One of the first songs he learned to play was Wheat Kings by Tragically Hip. He revisited this song in 2012 when he sang it again live at the MTV World Stage in Malaysia. Number 7. Bieber used to sing in front of the Avon Theater steps in his hometown when he was younger. He made around $3,000 despite constantly being chased away by the theater manager. He used that money to take his mom on their first ever vacation, a trip to Disneyland. Number 8. At age 12, Justin decided to unleash his musical talent on his hometown by entering the Stratford Star Contest. He placed second, but first in everyone's hearts. Number 9. In 2007, Bieber began posting videos of him singing covers of hits by artists like Justin Timberlake and Usher on YouTube, and slowly but surely started to gain tens, hundreds, and then thousands of subscribers with his silky smooth voice. The video sharing site would soon become the platform that would launch his career as a pop star. Number 10. Eventually, Scooter Braun, a guy plugging away at a career in hip-hop marketing, accidentally stumbled upon one of Justin's videos and knew he had a hitmaker on his hands. Number 11. Scooter Braun creeped out Justin and his mom just a little because before he reached out to the singer personally, he reportedly contacted his great aunt as well as the school board. Number 12. After tracking Justin down with some clever Googling, Braun offered to manage him and had him flown to Atlanta to record some demo tracks at the tender age of 13. Number 13. The trip to Atlanta was the first time Bieber had flown on a plane. How times have changed, as Bieber now frequently rides around in private jets. Number 14. In between sessions, the duo ran into Usher in the parking lot. Since Usher was once one of Justin's idols, he offered to sing for the world-renowned artist right on the spot. Usher politely declined. Number 15. After some coaxing from Braun and a well-timed name drop of Justin Timberlake, who was also interested in mentoring the boy, Usher decided to take a chance and help the kid get signed to Island Def Jam. Number 16. Usher officially introduced the world to Justin Bieber in April of 2009 at a much-hyped LA press conference. His first single, One Time, was released as well. Number 17. At only 15, Justin released his debut album, My World, in 2009. Coincidentally, Usher was also 15 when he released his own self-titled debut album. My World enjoyed the same success as One Time and also went platinum in the US and in Canada. Number 18. Bieber's follow-up, Baby, was another hit as well. Justin co-wrote the song with Christopher's Tricky Stewart, Tarius the Dream Nash, Ludacris, and Christina Milian. Number 19. It's no secret that Drake and Lil Twist were in the same music video, but did you notice that Tinashe also made a cameo? This was before the singer was as widely known as she is today.
Number 20. 2010 saw the release of Justin's 3D concert documentary film, Never Say Never, which was a huge commercial success, with over 12.35 million in ticket sales. It came in second place at the box office its first week, just behind Adam Sandler's romantic comedy, Just Go With It. Number 21. By the time the film left theaters 13 weeks later, it grossed nearly $100 million worldwide. To this day, it holds the record for highest grossing concert film. It's the third highest grossing documentary, just behind March of the Penguins and Fahrenheit 9/11. Number 22. To satiate the appetites of Beliebers, Never Say Never the Remixes was released shortly after the movie premiered. The track featured a multitude of mega pop stars like Miley Cyrus, Chris Brown, Kanye West, and more. Beliebers jumped to buy it, propelling the album to hit number one on the Billboard charts. Number 23. While he was out on his very first world tour, the entire planet seemingly caught Bieber fever. He was named the internet's most searched for celebrity in July of 2010. Number 24. Justin was accompanied at every tour by his mother, his manager, and a swagger coach that Usher hired to train the young heartthrob on the best ways to deal with his newfound fame. Number 25. The success of the tour and the film, along with the strong album sales, helped Justin get named Forbes magazine's Best Paid Celebrities Under 30 list, where he came in second behind Lady Gaga. Number 26. The star power just kept rolling in for the Biebs, and during the 2010 holiday season, he dropped his first festival holiday record, Under the Mistletoe, which involved collaborations with soulful 90s a cappella group Boyz II Men, the band Perry, Mariah Carey, and of course, his mentor, Usher. Number 27. It debuted a number one on the Billboard 200, making the album his third to reach the top of the charts. Bieber had released three number one albums before he turned 18. This Christmas album was also the first album by a male artist to debut at number one in Billboard history. Number 28. Bieber returned to the music scene with a darker, more mature sound in 2012 after pairing up with the legendary music producer Max Martin, as well as Diplo and Darkchild, who collaborated with the singer on hits like Boyfriend, Beauty and a Beat, and As Long as You Love Me. Number 29. Just after that, Justin got another highly prized award, his high school diploma. He was named a graduate of St. Michael Catholic Secondary School, although he didn't attend the cap and gown ceremony. He finished with an impressive 4.0 GPA. Number 30. In an effort to cultivate a more mature sound, Biebs started working with more hip-hop artists and producers, confirming that he was working on new tracks over the summer of 2013. Number 31. He began releasing new songs in the fall through his Music Monday series, featuring a more R&B-centric sound than Beliebers were previously used to. Number 32. In December, he unleashed the final product on the masses, the compilation album Journals. Number 33. The album was a fairly stark departure from his previous teen pop hits and featured collaborations with Future, Big Sean, Chance the Rapper, Lil Wayne, and even R. Kelly. Number 34. After realizing he had personal issues, the singer spent much of his time traveling in 2014 and then returned for Comedy Central Roast in March of 2015. This appearance was important because for many people, it was his reckoning. He finally got the butt kicking he deserved, and he took it quite well. Number 35. Following the public lashings in Comedy Central, Bieber said, "I've turned a lot of people off in the last few years, but I know I can still put good music out and turn everything all around." So far, the singer seems to be on the right track. Number 36. It ranks as the third most popular Comedy Central roast of all time, only behind Jeff Foxworthy and Charlie Sheen, the king of meltdowns. 4.5 million people tuned in to see the episode. Number 37. Though his musical career laid relatively dormant in 2014, Bieber came roaring back into the scene with a new attitude in 2015 when he collaborated with Skrillex and Diplo on their new project, Jack U. The main reason the three wanted to work together? In Diplo's words, because no one would expect it. Number 38. The trio's single, Where Are You Now, was essentially a remix off a song of My World 2.0 with the same name. The song was a sleeper hit, remaining on the Billboard Hot 100 for 18 weeks and peaking at number 8. Number 39. The high-pitched part of the song that sounds an awful lot like a flute is actually just a highly modified version of Justin Bieber's voice. Skrillex calls it the dolphin. Number 40. To further cement his comeback, Bieber enlisted the help of fellow A-listers like Mariah Carey, Kelly Clarkson, Ariana Grande, and Big Sean to aid in his social media campaign promoting the release of What Do You Mean? Starting on July 29th, 2015, every day for 30 days, he would post a picture of a celebrity holding a sign bearing the song title. Number 41. Before the release of his single What Do You Mean, Biebs direct messaged 49 random Twitter followers different lyrics for the track. Each lyrical message had a clock animation with a different time so the Beliebers could attempt to organize the lyrics if they wanted. Number 42. The clever marketing ploy for What Do You Mean worked as the track tied with 5 Seconds of Summer's Amnesia for longest running number one in Billboard's chart history. Number 43. It was Justin Bieber's first time atop the singles charts, though he had 46 songs previously hit the Billboard Hot 100. That's the longest a Hot 100 artist has waited for their first number one. He waited over 6 years. Number 44. Bieber is the youngest male artist ever to have a single debut at number one in the Hot 100. What Do You Mean was also his first number one Hot 100 credit as a producer and writer. Number 45. Where Are You Now re-entered the top 10 the same week, marking the first time the Biebs had ever notched 2 songs in the top 10 at the same time. Number 46. For the first time in 5 years, Bieber performed at the 2015 MTV VMAs, and it's considered one of his best performances to date. Afterward, Justin keeled over in tears, unable to fathom the amount of overwhelming support and love he felt from fans, and the warm reception he received from the audience. Number 47. To hype up fans for the release of his album, Bieber teamed up with graffiti artists to install creative murals that showcase the titles of the songs all around the world. The locations included Australia, United Kingdom, Sweden, France, Norway, Germany, New York, Pennsylvania, Washington, D.C., Canada, Massachusetts, Florida, Georgia, Illinois, Washington, and California.
Number 48.
There are 5 different wax figures of Justin Bieber at Madame Tussauds Wax Museum. Number 49. His next single, Sorry, debuted at number 2 on the charts. After 8 weeks, it finally slid into the number 1 spot, forcing Adele's Hello to say goodbye to the top of the charts. Number 50. Sorry set a new Billboard record by staying atop the charts for 7 weeks, breaking the previous record of 6 weeks set by none other than, yep, Justin Bieber himself. Number 51. While Sorry was gaining heat, Justin's 4th studio album was finally released. The record was called Purpose, and it debuted at number 1 on the Billboard 200. It was his 5th debut at the top and his 6th album to reach number 1. It sold an impressive 522,000 copies in its first week. Number 52. The next single from Purpose, called Love Yourself, also climbed its way to the top of the Hot 100 chart, making a stop at the number 2 spot along the way while Sorry was still peaking. This feat made Justin Bieber the 17th artist in Billboard Hot 100 history to hold the top 2 spots simultaneously. Number 53. Love Yourself was co-written by Ed Sheeran. It was the first time being number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 chart as a songwriter. He'd previously reached number 2 with his own song, Thinking Out Loud. Number 54. The music video for Love Yourself features husband and wife dancers Keon and Mary Madrid dancing their way through their house. Paris Goebel, the founder of the New Zealand Request dance crew, directed the clip. She also choreographed Justin Bieber's Sorry visual. Number 55. Bieber was the first male artist with 3 chart toppers from the same album since ex-Possible mentor Justin Timberlake achieved the feat nearly 10 years earlier, during a time when Timberlake was just figuring out what his musical talent was worth, showing it to the masses. Number 56. Third time's a charm. 5 years after his first nomination, Bieber finally won a Grammy in 2016. He received the award for Best Dance Recording, shared with Skrillex and Diplo for the song Where Are You Now? Number 57. Bieber loves his tattoos. He has too many to accurately count, including a full sleeve on one arm and a half sleeve on the other. But one of his favorites is the initials LL emblazoned on his inner upper arm. He says it serves as a reminder to lift his head up when it's low. Number 58. His first tattoo was of a bird. The bird is based on his favorite children's book, Jonathan Livingston's Seagull, about a seagull who wanted to be something more. Number 59. And although he doesn't make it back to his hometown too often these days, Bieber said that if he could take a plane anywhere on a moment's notice, he would return home and eat a quarter chicken dinner at Swiss Chalet. Who knew? The young man who can sing like a bird loves all aspects of avian culture. Number 60. Even animals can't control themselves around Justin Bieber. During the music video shoot for One Less Lonely Girl, a puppy in the video peed on the pop star. Number 61. Bieber sold his Calabasas mansion to Khloe Kardashian and currently lives in a suite in a Beverly Hills hotel. Before Justin Bieber, the mansion belonged to Britney Spears. Number 62. Bieber had a small part on CSI Las Vegas season 11. He played Jason McCain, who was a serial killer and bomber on the show for 2 episodes. As expected, it didn't end too well for his character. Number 63. Bieber joined the popular social media messaging app Snapchat in 2015 and goes by the username Rick the Sizzler. His verified emoji for Snapchat is praying hands emoji. Number 64. Who has more Twitter followers, Justin Bieber or the population of Canada? If you picked Bieber, you've got it. He is the 2nd most followed person on Twitter behind Katy Perry and beating out Taylor Swift at 3rd. Number 65. Bieber was so popular on Twitter that they had to ban his name from the trending topics list. Twitter cited that it was actually a shift in their algorithm to showcase emerging topics and things happening right now. Number 66. Believers revolted and got terms like Bustin' Jeeber and Tweeber trending instead as a loophole. Is it too late now to say sorry? Number 67. If anything, being thrust into the professional world so young afforded Bieber a ton of opportunities to do cool stuff with his money. For instance, he's an avid investor in the tech world and was one of the first celebrities to put money into Spotify. Number 68. Bieber also helped launch an anti-bullying selfie app called Shots, which is fitting since he sure loves those selfies. Number 69. Bieber said in a GQ interview that he's not a huge fan of texting, mostly because he doesn't want people to feel like it's not easy to get in contact with them. Number 70. Justin Bieber's hidden talent? He can solve a Rubik's Cube in under 2 minutes. Talented and smart. Number 71. In 2011, Bieber got a haircut and sold his chopped locks for a whopping $40,668 on eBay. He donated the proceeds to the Gentle Barn Foundation. Number 72. Unfortunately, even though it was for charity, he ended up losing 80,000 followers on Twitter after he showcased the haircut. Number 73. Justin has been actively involved with the Make-A-Wish Foundation, and so far has made over 250 wishes come true by meeting fans. Number 74. Though Justin claimed that the monkey on his shoulder at the Comedy Central roast was Mally, the pet he abandoned in Germany, it actually was not. Justin never saw Mally again after leaving Germany, and the monkey at the roast was a stunt double. However, the Biebs did have to pay over $10,700 in fees owed to the German government for the care of Mally. Number 75. In 2015, Bieber faced the Roots drummer Questlove in a rematch for a drum battle they originally had on The Tonight Show in 2010. On the 2010 show, Questlove destroyed the Biebs, but this time around, Biebs outdrummed Quest. Number 76. Bieber is the first artist to hit over 10 billion views on the YouTube service Vevo. That's impressive, considering that he raked in 4 billion views in only 6 months after releasing Purpose. Number 77. Justin loves skateboarding and frequently posts snippets of him grinding rails on his Instagram. The What Do You Mean music video has some scenes set in a skate park. Number 78. Bieber collaborates 100% with his stylist on his outfits. He's really into fashion and layering clothes. He owns a massive collection of vintage t-shirts ranging from Nirvana to Marilyn Manson. Bieber's stylist said that he's really a skater boy. That's what he really looks like. Many of the looks from Purpose promotional period reflect this style. Number 79. Bieber was the new face of Calvin Klein's Spring 2015 campaign. In their promo video featuring the singer, Bieber has an impromptu drum session and embraces a model while sporting the brand's boxers. Hashtag my Calvins.
Alright guys, are you ready? It is time for another lightning round, Justin Bieber edition. We're covering the stories behind how his songs came about. Let's do this.
Number 80. My Favorite Girl was dedicated to Taylor Swift.
This song, right here. Dedicated to you, Taylor Swift.
Early on, Swift used the song one time for one of her video diaries, so as a response, Justin Bieber dedicated this song to her. Number 81. Never Say Never was used as the inspirational theme song for the Karate Kid remake in 2010. However, the original demo for the song was for Travis Garland, and the lyrics had a much more sexual undertone, with lines like, "We're so sexy together when we touch hotter than the summer weather." Number 82. Ironically, Justin says the word never 69 times total in his song Never Say Never. Number 83. The song Maria is about Mariah Yeater. Back in 2011, then 20-year-old Mariah Yeater accused Justin of being her baby's father. To refute her claim, Justin took a paternity test, and Yeater later dropped the allegations. Lyrics for the tune include, "Maria, why do you want to do me like that? She ain't my baby, she ain't my girl." Number 84. Turn to You was dedicated to Justin's mom, Patty. Justin is extremely grateful for all of his mom has done for him as a single parent and wrote her this song for Mother's Day. Number 85. Down to Earth is a ballad about the feelings Bieber had when his parents split up and how he helped his family get through it. Number 86. What Do You Mean focuses on his feelings for Selena Gomez while they were still in a relationship together and never really understanding what she wanted. In the music video, you can see Selena graffitied at the skate park in one of the scenes. Number 87. Sorry is also another single that Bieber confirmed was written for Selena Gomez. The song is about missing an ex-lover and wishing that you could say sorry. Number 88. Mark My Word from Purpose is another apologetic single that is confirmed to be about Gomez and Bieber's on and off again relationship status.
Woo! That is it. So, how many of those did you guys know? What other songs have backstories that we missed? If you guys know some, leave us a comment because we love hearing from you guys. Now, back to the facts.
Number 89. Back in 2011, Justin Bieber and Selena Gomez crashed a wedding after overhearing them playing One Less Lonely Girl. Justin posed for pictures with a surprised and excited wedding guests. Number 90. Bieber loves boxing. His favorite boxer? Floyd Mayweather. Bieber has made several appearances at Mayweather's matches. Number 91. For his My World tour, Bieber visited over 75 cities. He also donated $1 for each ticket sold to Pencils of Promise, a nonprofit organization that builds schools and funds education initiatives in other countries. Number 92. Prior to his Purpose tour, Bieber used to have a tradition where he would bring a fan on stage and serenade them with the song One Less Lonely Girl. Number 93. Bieber stated that Be Alright was his favorite song that he wrote on his Believe album. Number 94. His favorite number is 6. It was Bieber's hockey jersey number growing up. Number 95. Johnny Depp surprised Justin Bieber at his hotel once with his favorite hat as a gift. Talk about famous fans. Number 96. Justin Bieber is all about his faith. He even got baptized in 2014 in former New York Knicks player Tyson Chandler's bathtub. Number 97. Bieber is a great babysitter. Not only does he regularly chase his siblings Jackson and Jasmine around, he also babysits for Mason Disick from time to time. Number 98. During a 2012 concert at the Apollo Theater, the tour faced a technical setback with a huge power outage. Luckily for the audience, the Biebs decided to jam on the drums while the crew worked together to get the power back on. Number 99. Justin Bieber nail polish anyone? He debuted his One Less Lonely Girl line of nail polishes by OPI in 2010. The collection includes iconic colors like baby blue and One Less Lonely Glitter. Number 100. The OPI deal is also one of the largest endorsement deals to date. It was reported that the company gave him $12.5 million to take part in the campaign. Number 101. The music video for I'll Show You was shot entirely in Iceland. Why? The director of the music video asked Justin, what's the one place he's always wanted to go and never been to? Iceland. Number 102. In the music video, Bieber jumps into the Jökulsárlón Glacier Lagoon in his underwear for a quick swim. The temperatures of the lake range from 3 to negative 3 degrees Celsius. That's about 37 to 27 degrees in Fahrenheit. Number 103. Bieber has a great sense of humor. He has pulled pranks on celebrities like Taylor Swift and Jaden Smith, and also on unsuspecting fans and haters. Number 104. Bieber is lucky that President Obama also has a sense of humor. Apparently, when the two met in 2011, instead of addressing him formally, Justin greeted the president by saying, "What up, my dude?" President Obama didn't seem to mind and playfully responded by saying, "What up, Biebs?" Number 105. As mentioned earlier, Bieber was born in the same hospital as Ryan Gosling and Rachel McAdams. Coincidentally, it turns out that The Notebook is one of his favorite movies of all time. Number 106. Justin Bieber enlisted the help of West Coast Customs to create his own Batmobile in 2011. Number 107. Though it seems like Justin's career will enjoy a long lifespan, the Biebs went ahead and released his own autobiography when he was only 16, entitled Justin Bieber: First Steps to Forever. Once again, guys, I'm Lauren Mayhew, and you just finished watching Mike Drops 107 Music Facts about Justin Bieber. Did you guys enjoy these facts? Make sure to subscribe because we are bringing you more facts about your favorite musicians every week. Let us know which artist you would like to see featured next, and we will see you guys next week.